Welcome to Tardy Party. Are you having to say double dry up Tardy Party?
No.
Welcome back to the Confluence Tap Room. It's been a while since we've been up here. I'm Josh, the production manager, and I'm joined by
Ashley, and I'm part of the cellar and brewing team.
And we're here to talk to you about another double dry hop Des Moines, and this one's brand new. This is grapefruit double dry hop Des Moines, as Ashley likes to call it, a tardy party.
I mean, it is a tardy party.
Yeah, so we haven't done a fruited IPA before. We've had like a few casks with some fruit in the tap room, but nothing on a larger scale. So it was kind of a matter of time before we did it, but this isn't a milkshake IPA. I'm not a huge fan of those. I don't know about you. Do you like milkshake IPAs?
I think it depends on how much lactose it has in it. My household is a lactose-sensitive house.
Fair enough.
I want to be able to enjoy my home alongside my boyfriend, so.
Makes sense. So, yeah, not a big fan of the milkshake IPAs. I feel like it often mutes the hops with all the sugar and fruit in it. So the goal was not to do that this time. Obviously, grapefruit is like a super low-hanging fruit to do as your first fruited IPA, since a lot of hops taste like grapefruit anyway. But we're kind of getting away from that with this New World, New Zealand hops going towards like passion fruit and pineapple and banana and those sorts of flavors. So we thought we'd treat this, as all our double dry hops Des Moines, treat this like a hazy, aside from the malt bill, which stays true to Des Moines, but we would sort of embrace kind of classic West Coast flavors, starting with the grapefruit puree. But then we picked the hops to feature the Lotus, Amarillo, and Simcoe specifically because they kind of all accentuate different aspects of the grapefruit. The Amarillo, some of that that bitter citrus and the resin that you get from a West Coast. The Simcoe is pretty similar and is also like the tie-in to the original Des Moines. Simcoe is in regular Des Moines IPA. And then Lotus, to give you some of that sweet orange sort of citrus character, try not to go too bitter because I know people like it to be fruity. So what do you think about this one?
Well, first and foremost, if you follow me on social media, you will know that I have a new puppy in my life. his name just so happens to be Lotus. So Lotus was always a favorite hop of mine, but it's obviously even more one of my favorites. But beer-wise, this one's gonna have that same similar base like Josh had mentioned. We wanna keep true and original to the Des Moines IPA, adding in those orange tart flavors. If you're a grapefruit fan, I think you're definitely going to feel and taste that grapefruit in there. It's going to bring you a little bit of that tartness, bring you into the tardy party. And we've got this beautiful label that represents the wonderful color of grapefruit. Grapefruit also has a special place in my heart. If any of you guys have snowbird grandparents and or parents, you know that they potentially might be having some orange trees or grapefruit trees in their yard. So I personally remember as a young child being able to pick fresh grapefruit from my grandparents' Arizona home. So that was really cool.
Even though we call it this tardy party, it's you know, it's not a sour. It's an IPA, and I think it embraces the IPA. It's soft, like the New England style, like the hazies, like the Extinction Event, like our other double dry hop, soft body thanks to that biotransformative yeast. But it's nice. It's got enough grapefruit bitterness that it sort of reminds me of when I started drinking IPAs and Pliny the Elder was like the hottest thing that you could get. And like just that flavor of resin and grapefruit and having a bitter IPA, and this is balanced but finishes bitter, is soft up front. I think it's really nice, and a good addition to the double dry hop team, I believe.
Yeah. Yeah. So I don't know about you, Josh, but what are you doing for Labor Day weekend?
Well, I don't know. I don't really have any plans. You got any ideas?
Well, we just so conveniently have this party over Labor Day weekend called Patio Fest. And I feel like if you can't make it out right away this weekend to grab this awesome beer, then maybe you should come out and listen to some music, pick up a new Des Moines IPA tea, drink some Des Moines IPA or its sister, and come have some fun. Hang out with the friends, bring your dog and hang out on the patio, listen to some good music, eat some food truck foods, and have a great time.
Yeah, we've got a bunch of live music acts lined up the 3rd through the 6th. Several acts each day, I think 9 in total over the weekend. Food trucks, should be a good time. So come join us for at least one day of the weekend and maybe more.
I mean, I'll probably be here at least one day, so.
All right, guys, check out our other video for the second release this week. Follow us on all social media. Come down, pick up a 4-pack of grapefruit. Let us know if you like it. You like that throwback West Coast flavor as much as we do. Cheers.